I know you got a lot of people that judge you from watching the TV show, and I mean, you know, if you think you're capable, it's as easy as you think it is. You can sure sign up and try out for next year and see how you get along.
You keep saying you want to be here, but I don't see that in your eyes. Do you want to be here?
100%.
Cole, I thank the world of you, man. You're going to have to gather your personals and hit the trail.
Good news, buddy. I appreciate it.
I don't think I could do anything any different because I woke up every morning and give everything 110%. I don't feel like I made any mistakes. The calf that we had, there was three calves, and that one calf, I may have caused him to get out or not. I can't say one way or the other, but when we got him in the corner, I did catch mine, and Hunter ran his through the fence. I mean, that's what threw me off. I mean, I did complete my challenge, and he didn't, so that's the reason I thought he should have went instead of me. Hunter's just young and really inexperienced. I just didn't think a lot of him before it was said and done. I know when I went to go back up that Hunter wasn't going to be there because I told Quentin and them to sure enough keep him away from me.
I said, y'all better take him and put him somewhere before I come back, is all I can tell you.
He just flat out basically called me a quitter and, you know, said I'd quit him and quit the team and this and that. That's the furthest thing from the truth. He did a lot of crying and whining, and for him to call me a quitter, that just rubbed me the wrong way. Since I left the show, I just came back home and picked up the things left off when I left. I talked to JP quite a bit. I talked to JC some. Tyler Kijak, I talked to him here and there. Fatty, we're still all pretty good friends. I mean, everybody that was left there after I left was definitely qualified. I really like JP. I think JP deserved it. JP worked hard. JP's a very humble individual. I think it would help him in the long run the most. You know, when I signed up for this deal, I didn't know what I was in for. I'm friends with Zane Runyon, who was your winner last year, and he kind of briefed me a little bit on the deal. But our deal was totally different than their deal as far as accommodations and that. I was kind of briefed that we might have to camp. I'm like, they really realize it's like 115, 120 degrees here during the day. It's not going to be great at all to sleep in a tent. You know, it's going to be pretty horrible, actually. You're not only competing with these other 13 people, you're living completely with these other 13 people in the same space, the same shower, the same bathroom. I mean, you're sharing your entire life. You're mic'd up, you're working for you guys, you know, the whole time you're there. And I mean, your phone's taken away, you don't really catch up with family or friends or work or really know what's going on in the outside world. I mean, you get a little bit here and there, but you're not really keeping up with all that. One thing I learned is you can sure get by on the bare minimum. You know, I've never been a camper. I've never had to be in that situation. And I mean, as long as you can get a shower at the end of the day and find somewhere to lay down, you can survive, but it's just not as much fun.